Happy morning. Children, there is something special today. Okay, today I'm going to show you something. Okay, I guess some of you might be knowing what is it. No? Okay, this is a bit surprise for you. Okay, I know all of you are working hard. Okay, all of you are giving your best to do for your UT exam. Okay, and I found one of you is doing very beautifully. Okay, I know many of you are doing it very beautifully, but I got a video for you. Okay, please watch this and then I'll tell you more about this. Okay. This was about Kaushal Panchal. Okay, he's very studious and see the tricks that is using. Okay, when you're writing na, when you speak every word loudly and then you write it, it's really easy for you to concentrate on your studies, because when you're speaking it loud na, you are just concentrating only on one thing, and that is what you're focusing is your studies. Okay, so keep a habit of writing things very beautifully as well as saying it aloud while you're writing. Okay, so that is a very good habit. All of you are very good. Okay, so I'm expecting that more of you come together and we'll make our class the best one. Okay, so I want all of you to study well, to prepare well and score very good marks in your UT exam. So let's continue with our today's chapter. Happy morning, a very happy and cheerful morning to all my children. So here I am, and today we are going to continue with the subject English grammar. Okay, and chapter number 4, we are doing chapter number 4, nouns. Okay, well, let's read the definition and understand this thing more clearly. Okay, over here we have countable and uncountable. Okay, just note the spelling. Okay, don't make a mistake while you're writing the definition. For countable nouns, which can be counted are countable nouns. Now you might be thinking, counted, that means I have to count it 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, you are thinking it right. Okay, see, if they are using nouns with numbers, if I say I have 2 pens, then which is the noun? Pen is the noun, and I have mentioned the number 2. Okay, so that is what? That is countable noun. Okay, let's see with few of the examples over there. The first one you have, I want all of you to take your textbooks with you, page number 2020. Okay, we have examples: eggs, books, pencils, boxes. See, we have 4 eggs, 3 books, 3 pencils, 3 boxes. Okay, so this is what? This is example of countable noun, when the noun is counted. Okay, and the next one, nouns which cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. So if you have numbers with the noun, that is countable. Okay, and if you don't have the numbers, you don't have the count, okay, with the noun, then we call it uncountable nouns. You have the examples: bread. Have they mentioned how many? No. Then we have food. That's again single. Okay, we don't know which food, how many, all these things. Milk, not mentioned. Salt. Okay, so what is this? This is uncountable nouns. Okay, so nouns which are not counted are called uncountable nouns. Though we cannot count uncountable nouns, we can count them in some other manner. Okay, let's see how we can count them in some other manner. Now, here suppose we have 2 bread. Do we say 2 bread? No, we say 2 slices of bread. Okay. Next, 3 tea. Do we say 3 tea? No, We call it 3 cups of tea. Okay, so there are certain ways of presenting the countable noun. Okay, let's go for the third example. 2 soaps. Do we say that 2 soap? Give me 2 soaps. No, we say give me 2 cakes of soap because it is having 2 cubes. Okay, so 2 cakes of soap. So in this way, when you are mentioning it now, we call it countable noun. Okay, and let's move forward. See, they are giving you the examples: 2 slices of bread, 3 cups of tea, 2 cakes of soap. Okay, so these all things comes under the category of countable nouns. So here today we learned about 2 things. That is, the first definition is countable noun and the second one uncountable. I want all of you to open page number 2020, okay, and mark the definition over there. All of you take your book over there. The first line: nouns which can be counted are countable nouns. And over there you have the examples: eggs, books, pencils, boxes. Okay, and the next one: nouns which cannot be counted are uncountable nouns. Okay, and which are they? For that we have bread, food, milk. Okay, these things. So children, I want all of you to just tick the countable and uncountable nouns on your textbook in the K part. Okay, so let's start. So here we have tick countable nouns and cross the uncountable nouns. Okay, so I have shown you the examples. For countable we have eggs, books, pencil, boxes, the things that we can count. Okay, for uncountable we have the things that we can't count, like food, air, water, bread, salt. These things we can't count it. Okay, so let's check it out. From here we have to tick the countable and cross over the uncountable. Let's check it out. The first one: coin. What is coin? Can you count coins? Yes, you can count the coins. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that is countable. Next one: books. Can you count the books? Yes. So how many books are there on my hand? 1, 2, 2 books. Okay, so you can count the books also. So that is countable noun. Let's go for the third one: pen. Okay, so how many pens are there on my hand? 1, 2, 2 pens. Again, you can count the pens. So we can give countable nouns for pen. Fourth one: air. Air, can you count it? No. Can you touch it? No. It's just a feeling. Okay, we can't count it. So that is uncountable noun. So put a cross over there. Okay. Fifth one: water. Can you count water? No. We can count how many bottles of water we have. Yeah. So that is again a cross, uncountable noun. Okay, let's go for the next one: bread. As I told you in the example, we don't say we have 2 breads. We say I have 2 slices of bread. Okay, so bread is again uncountable noun. Okay, seventh one: milk. Can you count milk? No, we can't count anything in liquid. Okay, so again it is uncountable. Okay, eighth one: soap. Do you say I have 2 soaps? No. What we say? Yes, you're right. We say that I have 2 cakes of soap. Okay, so again this is what? Yes, it is uncountable noun. Okay, so children, I want to all of you to take a page number 20 and put the tick marks on your textbook. Okay, and then you will be writing these things in your notebook. So you'll be writing the definition of countable and uncountable, 3 examples for them each. Okay, then you'll be writing this exercise: tick countable and cross uncountable noun. Okay, and then will be your chapter will be completed over here. Okay, so here we are winding up for the day. I want all of you to note these things properly in your textbooks, and then you have to write them neatly in your notebook also. Ma'am will be uploading the answers for the same soon in Teams. Okay, so till then, all of you take care. Have a nice day.